بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وبه نستعين، وأصلي وأسلم على نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين ومن تبعهم إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، respected brothers, sisters and beloved children, inshallah I will be sharing some reflection from Juz 3. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying in Surah Baqarah at 254, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, O people who has been blessed with Islam, who has been blessed with Iman, who believe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as the creator, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as the messenger, Quran is the last revelation and Islam is the final religion, anfiqu, spend for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, give for the charity, give for the humanity, help the masajid, help the madaris, help Islamic institution, help fuqara, du'afa, masakin, less fortunate people who are suffering, struggling and during their days and night. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us with something, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, O my slave, spend. Ya Allah, spend from where? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying further, وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ, whatever you has been blessed with, spend from your income, spend from your job, spend from your revenue, and spend from the businesses. Whatever the source or the means of income you have a bank balance, you have worldly belonging, you have a gold and silver, your business is booming, your income is increasing, mashallah, all the joy and happiness you are getting, oh my slave, just remember that. You're not getting this and you're not having this because you deserve. You has been blessed with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honor you with his blessing in the form of worldly belonging. So whenever any call are made for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the humanity, for the community, don't hold your belonging, don't hold your gold and silver, but in fact spend today before it gets too late. Don't wait for tomorrow, because tomorrow you may be willing to spend, but it will be too late. Why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, يَوْمٌ لَا بَيْعٌ فِيهِ وَلَا خُلَّةٌ وَلَا شَفَاعٌ. Today, you have worldly belonging in the form of gold and silver, job or businesses, or the bank balances, you have your control. Today, just remember, tomorrow you may not have a control on anything because there is no dealing, no buying and selling, no meeting and greeting. But in fact, whatever you have done today, everything will be based on the deed you have performed in this dunya and has been given for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Almighty. The day of the Qiyamah, there won't be any relation, there won't be any concession, there won't be any dealing of businesses with one another. So if you're waiting for tomorrow, don't do that. Because tomorrow you want to do that, but you may not be able to do that. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, why you're holding? Do you think that this is not Allah's fadl? If you think it's yours, for how long you will be keeping? You will be enjoying from the worldly belonging, from the gold and silvers, or the bank balance. For the 60, 70, 80, 100 and 120, the person name goes to the Guinness Record Book. And just remember that. After that, anyway, you will be resurrected in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah says, وَالْكَافِرُونَ هُمَ الظَّالِمُونَ. Those people who have rejected Allah's commands, prophet teaching, and whenever the call and cause was made to show your help and support, you can give and donate, but we hold it at that moment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, oh my slave, just remember, tomorrow you'll regret forever. And then further, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, in relevant to the charity, help the needy, communities and society, ayah number 261 from Surah Al-Baqarah, Beautifully, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving example for those people who take part in the good causes, who give help hand for the needies, for the communities. Whenever the call has been made for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they don't delay, but in fact, they rush and they run based on their capacity and capability, whatever they can do. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying example of those people, مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. Whenever a call has been made and they rush to spend and play their contributions, a donation for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and follow His instruction and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam recommendation, is example of the one grain seed which has been placed. From one grain seed, 7 crop of the grain came, and each crop carries 100 grain. So the 7 crops will carry 700 grain seed. Subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, O my slave, believe on me, if you spend dollar for my sake, if you spend dollar for my sake, surely I will give you in return 700 times minimum. For the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, that is not a maximum. Wallahu yudha'ifu liman yasha'. Based on your sincerity, honesty, that whether you're giving for Almighty or you have your name and fame, if you have just given just solely and only for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, يُضَاعِفُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. I will increase to the degree that is only in the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My respected brother, what a wonderful example Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to encourage us all. So make sure whenever the call or the causes has been placed in front of ourselves, and if we can do anything, make sure we do it. If we can contribute $1,000, for example, that's great. If we cannot contribute $1,000, no problem. What about a $500? We should. If not a $500, maybe $100. If not $100, maybe $1. We shouldn't be thinking and seeing, I'm only able to donate $1 for the God's sake. Let's remember, my brothers and sisters and beloved children, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala don't look at our faces and our positions. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala don't look towards the quantity, but He looks towards the quality. If we have given a $1, which solely and only for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward us as like giving hundreds of thousands of dollars. But if he has given $100,000, but an intention one, just a name and fame, just remember that money has gone, no doubt there will be a humiliation in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So whatever we are giving and we are able to give, don't delay. For the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so we can achieve the goodness of this dunya, and hereafter we can be blessed with Allah's pleasure. And for the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, Surah Baqarah, ayat number 262, how we should be giving. الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. Those people who rush towards the call of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala whenever it has been made, subhanallah. الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. Who spend for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the various ways, whether helping the masajid, the musallas, the madaris, Islamic institution, humanitarian organizations, helping a needy, a masakeen, fuqara, duafa, giving help hands to the neighbors, to any human being who is seeking our help. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, there is a huge reward for those people. ثُمَّ لَا يُتْبِعُونَ مَا أَنْفَقُوا مَنَّا وَلَا. If they has given just only and only and solely for the Allah's sake. لَا يُتْبِعُونَ مَا أَنْفَقُوا مَنَّا وَلَا أَذَا. Their contribution, their donation, their collaboration wasn't for the name and fame that sometime we give for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then we start boasting, I give to this masjid and that musallah and this organization and that family or that individual, otherwise this organization may have clapped down long time ago. My respected brother, being very honest, and this is what I believe in regards to myself, if Allah is using me, or if Allah is using you, if Allah is using you, or if Allah is using me for any good causes, for any good causes, anyhow. Never boast that the work of a deen, the work of religion, the work of humanity, the work of a kindness is surviving, is running just of me, because of me and you. Allah don't need me and Allah doesn't need you. Allah need no one. But whenever the call has been made, by taking a part and contributing, donating, we are doing a favor to our own self, not anyone else. So Allah is saying, ثُمَّ لَا يُتْبِعُونَ مَا أَنْفَقُوا مَنَّا وَلَا أَذَىٰ. Whenever you hear a call in regards to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to help the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, help the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, help the needies, help the societies and the communities, and you're able to do so, and you're taking some part and giving some portion, don't boast yourself at all that you have done this and you have done that. You have helped to this masjid, you have helped to that organization, you have given to this family or you have given to that family. They thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, cry in fact in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by thanking that Allah make you able and capable, that instead of begging in front of someone, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make you able to help someone. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, who will be having solely and sincerely mentality by giving a help hand and helping one another just only and solely for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving a glad tiding. لَهُمْ أَجْرُهُمْ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ. In this dunya, in a return, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be giving minimum 107 will equal to 700. And that is a minimum. Wallahu yudha'ifu liman yasha', and Allah will multiply to the level that is in the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what about hereafter? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, lahum ajruhum 'inda rabbihim. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reserve a special rewards, subhanallah, for those people who honor the call of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala whenever it was made in front of them. And then Allah says, وَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. The dunya will be made full of joy and happiness. They will have all the qualities and the beauties, relax and contentment. And when they will be resurrected hereafter, وَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. Subhanallah. When everyone will be looking here and there, everyone will be thinking and concerning of themselves, saying, Nafsi, Nafsi, what will happen to me? Whether I will be going toward the right side, which is the paradise, or whether I will be falling to the left hand, which is the hellfire. At that moment, when the humanity, each and everyone, will be worried, there will be panic. You know what will happen to those people who are giving a charity? Showing the kindness, giving a help hand, وَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْدَنُونَ. They will be painless. They will be having a smile on their faces. And top of that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will honor them with His pleasure. My respected brothers, sisters and beloved children, we came to know from the lifestyle of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his generosity. And he always was very, very, very generous throughout the whole year. But when the month of Ramadan used to come in his life, subhanallah, his generosity was faster than a wind. That he always used to give a help hand. Any call used to come, any demands, any request from humanity, from the community, from any individual or the family, he always used to sacrifice what he used to have without thinking and without caring that he has something to eat or not, or what he will be eating. Many times that happened to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he just has something for himself, but any call was made from any family or any individual that they need help. What happened? Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam took that means and has hand over to the others who asked for it, to show the example of generosity, akhlaq, a moral for entire community and humanity, that you cannot be, you may be a human, but you may not be blessed with the humanity if you don't care for others before you care for yourself. And this is the teaching of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving a huge reward on spending for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My respected brothers, sisters and beloved children, and whoever is listening to me, What could be better time than this? That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has honored us with the blessment of Ramadan, that if we do bit, we'll get a lot. We'll get a lot from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So whatever means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us, and whatever we can do, never see any number, because the number is not a matter in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But if anything is matter, that is a quality which call a sincerity, ikhlas. So make sure every day, every night in fact, we should donate to the masajids, to the musallas, and help to needy, less fortunate people who don't have sufficient to survive their life. They're struggling during a days and night, so they can have a right to live in this dunya, and they can live and eat and drink as we are eating and drinking. And that is only possible that if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us, so make sure we show our role by giving a help hand in the various ways and means, whatever we can do so. In the return, definitely Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant us a lot in this dunya, and hereafter, when we'll be resurrected, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant us a huge reward on top of that, which is greater than anything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will honor us with His pleasure. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all the tawfiq to give a charity based on our capacity and capability. Ma'a salam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.